Okay, I just need you to picture this just for a second. A warm, rich, gooey chocolate center oozing out of a perfectly soft, melt-in-your-mouth chocolate cake. If that sounds like dessert heaven to you, then this easy chocolate lava cake recipe is exactly what you need. It's so decadent, comes together quickly with only a handful of ingredients, and leaves you feeling like you've just walked out of one of the best patisseries in town. So to start off, you want to preheat your oven to 220°C or 430°F conventional, so no fan function. And generously grease and flour 3 6-ounce ramekins. They should be roughly around 3.5 inches or 9 centimeters in diameter. If they're a little smaller or bigger, it's fine. It just means that you may need to adjust the cooking time slightly. So I've greased my ramekins with a generous amount of butter, and now I'm just going to coat the bottoms and sides with some all-purpose flour. Remember to get rid of any excess flour by tapping your ramekins gently, and that excess flour will just fall out. Now, once all the ramekins are done, you just want to set them aside for now. And next, in a heat-proof bowl, add in 113 grams or 1/2 cup of unsalted butter and 170 grams or about 1 cup or 6 ounces of semi-sweet chocolate. I usually use a 50 to 60% dark chocolate, and you want to make sure that you're using a good quality chocolate block that, you know, you can eat. You don't want to use chocolate chips or even compound chocolate, otherwise the center of your lava cakes aren't going to be, you know, that kind of nice gooey texture. So you can either melt the butter and chocolate together over a double boiler or do it in the microwave, which is what I do simply because I find it quicker and easier. So you just want to melt it for 20 second bursts, giving it a mix in between each burst until the chocolate is almost melted. Once it's at that stage, just keep stirring the mixture, allowing the residual heat to melt the remaining chocolate. And this is just going to prevent you from overheating or burning your chocolate. So once you have a smooth liquidy mixture like this, then you just want to set this chocolate butter mixture aside for now. And next, in a large bowl, add in 50 grams or 1/4 cup of light soft brown sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla, 1/8 teaspoon of salt, 2 whole eggs, and then 2 egg yolks, which I've already separated from the whites earlier on. So egg yolks are going to help achieve that kind of rich, creamy flavor that lava cakes have without adding too much structure to them. And then, using a hand or stand mixer on a medium speed, you want to whip this for about 5 minutes until the eggs are thick and pale in consistency. You should be able to lift up the batter with your attachments and kind of make ribbons with it, which sit on top of the batter for a few seconds before being absorbed back in. So once that's done, just get all of that, you know, batter off of your attachments. And then into the same bowl, you want to sift in 24 grams or 3 tablespoons of all-purpose flour. And then you also want to add in the melted chocolate mixture from earlier. And then, using a spatula, fold that in until everything is well combined and the batter is uniform. Okay, so that is our batter all done. It smells so, so good. And now you just want to evenly distribute this into our ramekins from earlier. Try not to make a mess like me. And then, once that's done, just give your ramekins a little tap on the bench top and then place them onto a baking tray. And now these are going to go into the oven for 11 to 12 minutes or until the lava cakes have puffed up a bit and are set on the edges but still slightly jiggly in the center. You don't want the center to be set, otherwise you won't have that lava coming out in the middle. So once the lava cakes are done, let them cool in the ramekins for about a minute, and then you want to turn them out onto your serving plates, and just make sure that you're using a towel or something while holding them because the ramekins will still be quite hot. And then you just want to let them rest for about 10 seconds before gently lifting the ramekins off. They should come off quite easily. And that is our lava cakes all done, and you want to serve them immediately while they're still nice and hot. Now, before serving, I like to just dust mine with some powdered sugar, and you can also add some berries, ice cream, or whipped cream on the side. I honestly cannot tell you guys how decadent these lava cakes are. They're so rich and creamy and full of chocolate flavor. These are also great to make ahead of time. So say you've got a dinner party at night, you can make the batter earlier in the day, pop them into the ramekins and just put them in the fridge, and then 30 minutes to, you know, 1 hour before you're going to serve them, just pull them out of the fridge to let the batter come to room temperature before baking them in the oven for, you know, that kind of 11 to 12 minute mark before serving them. And now for the best part, taste testing. Yes, you can see that beautiful lava coming out there. this is probably one of my favorite desserts of all time. It's just so like indulgent and luxurious to eat, and it's actually quite light as well. Like you could get through one of these relatively easily. So that is it for today, guys. If you do decide to give this lava cake a go, then please do leave a review on my blog. It really helps my content out, and I absolutely love hearing from you guys. For another one of my favorite chocolate recipes, check out my chocolate fudge cake recipe here, and I'll see you in the next video.